হ্যালো মাই ডিয়ার স্টুডেন্টস অফ 18 ব্যাচ, আসসালামু আলাইকুম। কেমন আছেন আপনারা সবাই? আশা করি সবাই সুস্থ আছেন, ভালো আছেন, সোশ্যাল ডিস্টেন্সিং মেনটেন করে চলছেন। আমি আফরোজা আহমদ রিঙ্কি আপনাদের সবাইকে ওয়েলকাম করছি আমাদের ফোর্থ অনলাইন লেকচারে। টুডে উইল বি কমপ্লিটিং চ্যাপ্টার 6 অফ স্ট্র্যাটেজিক ব্র্যান্ড ম্যানেজমেন্ট। দ্য চ্যাপ্টার্স নেম ইজ ইন্টিগ্রেটিং মার্কেটিং কমিউনিকেশন টু বিল্ড ব্র্যান্ড ইকুইটি। আই হোপ ইউ উইল লিসেন দ্য লেকচার ভেরি অ্যাটেন্টিভলি বিকজ ইটস আ ভেরি 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 ইম্পর্টেন্ট লেকচার। ওকে, লেটস গো টু আওয়ার লার্নিং অবজেক্টিভস। From this chapter, we will learn what are the changes in the new media environment. We will learn information processing model of communication. What are the major marketing communication options? How can you develop integrated marketing communication program? You will learn to identify the choice criteria for developing integrated marketing communication program. Also, you will learn some guidelines for general marketing communication programs. So students, these are the learning objectives. Now, marketing communication in 21st century. Students, this chapter actually provides a conceptual framework and managerial guideline how marketing communication can be integrated to increase brand equity. Now you all know it's 21st century, and in 21st century, marketing has been very different from its earlier beginnings. Today, marketers have more choices in terms of support, media opportunities, and communications. Marketers need to evaluate marketing communication options strategically to determine how these can contribute to brand equity. They also have more competition from varied sources, especially as the internet has made it possible for companies around the globe to compete virtually. So what we understood that marketing in 21st century has been very different. Also, the marketer has numerous options as well as he has to face numerous competitors. Now, media environment. Media environment is the social, psychological, and economic environment engendered by a particular media or a technology. So, when we talk about new media environment, it refers to the social, psychological, and economic environment that has been generated by a media. The changing era of 21st century has posed the marketer to face new challenges, and the most challenging part is building effective and efficient marketing program. Throughout our whole lecture, we will learn how can we build effective and efficient marketing program. The new media environment. We already learned that media environment is the social, technological, and personal media that is generated through any devices. So you see, traditional advertising media such as television, radio, magazines, and newspapers seem to be losing their grip on consumers. Why? Just take a moment to think. Do you spend your time on TV like you used to do before? No, because newer technologies have evolved. Marketers pour billions into internet advertising now, while web advertising jumped during this time, spending for TV ads remained flat. So we understand that in new media, the traditional advertising media has been superseded by the internet and interactive media. Marketing communication in first century. Students, there has been given an example in your book in the beginning of the chapter. The South Korean car company Hyundai made a brilliant communication strategy to communicate with the customers, and they understood the changes in the media. So what did they do? They choose more communication choices, more creative options, more consumer choices. There is social media streamlines, word of mouth, tried and true marketing techniques still work. So what does this mean? This means that if you want to communicate in 21st century, you have to be more creative. You have to be more creatively convey your messages through the media, and you have to remember the consumer choices. Students, now we will learn information processing model of communication now. For a person to be persuaded by any kind of communication, for the following six steps in the next slide must occur. If there is a breakdown in any step, then successful communication will not result. So what did you understood? Information processing model of communication has six steps. Let's take a look on them. Okay, so the first stage of the information processing model is exposure. A customer must see or hear about the marketing communication program. In the second stage, the customer must notice your communication program. In the third stage, the customer must understand what you are going to convey through your marketing program. In the fourth stage, the customer must respond to your marketing program. In the fifth stage, the customer must plan to act. Suppose you are showing advertisement and presentation to your customer. Now, if your customers are not willing to buy it, your program will not be successful. So in the final stage, they must actually act to purchase or to endorse your product. So information processing model has six steps. If a customer does not follow any one step, then the marketing communication program shall not be successful. Students, now we will learn what is integrated marketing communication. What are the major marketing communication options? It means there are many options through which you can communicate your customers. Now there are many we will learn in the slides. Okay, marketing communication are the means by which a firm attempts to inform, persuade, and remind customers of the product that the firm sells. So that means through your communication program, you are informing your customer, you are persuading your customer, or that's called convincing your customer to purchase, and you are reminding your existing customer of the products that your firm is selling. So we can say marketing communication informs, persuades, and reminds. Next, integrated marketing communication. In the previous slide C, we learned marketing communication. Now we shall learn integrated marketing communication. A company carefully integrates and coordinates its many communication channels to deliver a clear, consistent, and compelling message about the organization and its products. Students, maybe you already know a company usually uses many channels. For example, advertisement, sales promotion, public relation, personal selling, and other channels. In integrated marketing communication, our main objective is to integrate all these channels so our customer gets a clear message. Next, what is the objective of our marketing communication? See, marketing communication programs create brand knowledge in our customer's mind. This brand knowledge creates brand equity. So brand equity means the commercial value that derives from consumer perception of the brand name of a particular product or service rather than from the product or service itself. Khub kothin lagche tomader বাংলায় বলছি, ব্র্যান্ড ইকুইটি মানে হচ্ছে তোমার কাস্টমারের তোমার পণ্য সম্পর্কে একটা পারসেপশন রয়েছে, যে পারসেপশনটাকে তুমি চেঞ্জ করতে পেরেছো কিসে, কমার্শিয়াল ভ্যালুতে। তার মানে তোমার কাস্টমার তোমার প্রোডাক্টটাকে অন্যান্য কম্পিটিটিভ প্রোডাক্টের চেয়ে বেশি মূল্যায়ন করছে। এই ধরনের মূল্যায়নেরকে আমরা বাংলা ইংলিশে বলি ব্র্যান্ড ইকুইটি। আমাদের কমিউনিকেশন প্রোগ্রামের মেইন অবজেক্টিভ হচ্ছে current brand knowledge, as in the customer's current brand knowledge eta ache, we shall convert it into desired brand knowledge. For example, A customer's current brand knowledge about Dhaka City College is only discipline. Now, our objective will be to inform the customer's knowledge also about the good results and the positive sides of Dhaka City College. So in this way, through marketing communication, you change current brand knowledge into desired brand knowledge. Now comes major marketing communication options. Students, there are many marketing communications options. Basically, there are four: advertisement and promotion is together, but for the purpose of our discussion, I have divided them into two different parts. The first option is advertisement, the second option is promotion, the third option is event and experience marketing, then online and interactive marketing, then mobile marketing. So all of these are your options to communicate with your customer. Now we shall discuss about each of them broadly. Advertising. Advertising is a powerful means of creating strong, favorable, and unique brand associations and eliciting positive judgments and feelings. Advertisements are controversial because its specific effects are often difficult to quantify and predict. Nevertheless, a number of studies using very different approaches have shown the potential power of advertising on brand sales. Students, advertisement is the most popularly used options for marketing communication. Through advertisement, you are always trying to convey positive and intriguing messages to your customers. What will be in an ideal ad campaign, as in an ideal advertisement, what should be the things that you should ensure? The first one, in advertisement, the right consumer is exposed to the right message. The creative strategy for the advertisement should be noticeable to the customer. The ad properly should reflect the consumer's level of understanding. The ad properly should position the brand in terms of describable and deliverable points of differences and points of parity. The ad motivates consumers to consider purchase of the brand. The ad creates strong brand association. So we can summarize that if you are designing any ad campaign, you have to remember who are the right consumer. You have to remember how can you elicit positive brand awareness in their mind, and you have to declare the points of differences in your products or services in the advertisement. Now take a look at some creative advertisement. Just see, this is the example of a shampoo brand, and what they're doing, they are all of these cables are representing the hair, and they are showing how using rejoice can help you to have smooth hair. There are also some more advertisement. See, this is an advertisement of Pantene. Isn't it interesting how long and how smooth this hair looks? Then this was an advertisement for awareness. This is drug effects are devastating. Can you see? These are not trees. These are the picture of inside of your eye. Here is your eye, and you see this is a bloodshot eye. How notorious and dangerous it's looking because of drug effect. So this is also another creative advertisement. Now, category of advertisement. You can advertise through television, through radio, through print media, through direct response media. You can also advertise through a website and online. You can advertise through mobile. You can place advertisement on billboards, movies, airline lounges, and where not. Once Philip Kotler said that we are living in a world where there is no escape from advertisement. So all of these are the media by which you can advertise. Now, the second one, promotion. Students, promotion is basically of two kinds, that is consumer promotions and trade promotions. So, students, do you remember what is promotion? Promotion are the incentives that you are giving your customer for a short period to improve the sale of your product. You can give consumer promotion through providing sample, coupon, premium, refund, rebate, and contest, and many other options. Through consumer promotion, the price are decreased, so customers get products and services in a very less price. In trade promotion, how can you give trade promotion? Through trade promotion, you can push money to the customers who wants to have money, who wants to have money discounts. Then you can train them. You can show your products through trade shows with discount. You can have cooperative advertisement. So in consumer promotion and in trade promotion, actually you are giving incentives to your customer for short-term business boost. That is also another kind of marketing communication. Next, event marketing and sponsorship. Rationale: to identify with a particular target market or lifestyle, to increase awareness of the company, to create consumer perception of key brand image, to enhance corporate image, to create experience, to entertain key clients. Do you remember of some example of event marketing? For example, Lux Channel is superstar. For example, there are many actually close-up, then close-up Kachiyashar Golpo, then there are many thousand events that are always going on, and you can see today we see that every single programs that are telecast on television or any media that are actually sponsored by any company. So why do they do that? Why do they take this sponsorship? Because they want to show their social responsibility. Also, they want to improve their image in the market. So if the program is event is successful, it brings a huge profitability to the organization. Next, students, you can see multi-screen here. This is a television screen, this is a mobile screen, magazine, tablet, PC, newspaper, and mobile. So these all are many screens. As people use multi-screen devices, more and more time spent on media will increase. So when you are spending more and more time on media, what will happen? It creates an opportunity for you to do interactive marketing. Interactive marketing is a one-to-one marketing practice that centers on individual customer and prospect's actions. Interactive marketing involves marketing initiatives that are triggered by customers' behavior and preference. Students, interactive marketing means you are directly communicating with your individual customer according to their preference. You can do interactive marketing by website, by sending emails, by sending banner ads, by sending videos, message boards, chat rooms, by their blogs, by using Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, SEO. So interactive marketing is also called actually online marketing or e-marketing tools. This marketing tool is most widely used throughout the world now, because the future world is in interactive marketing tool, and through all of these tools you can use interactive marketing. Now, mobile marketing. Mobile marketing is a multi-channel digital marketing strategy aimed at reaching a target audience. Students, I know you all already know what is mobile marketing. You are reaching your customer through mobile devices. Importance. What are the importance? There are actually many. You can quickly access your customer. Mobile has become an undetachable part of life. So what happens? The company can easily reach their target customer. Mobile is not only used for e-shopping, but also used in physical store. Wherever you go, mobile is always with you. So mobile marketing will be very effective. You see, Today, all the companies are sending us SMS, and through SMS, they are actually doing permission marketing. Mobile search index become primary content for ranking and importance of mobile advertisement. Students, just take a moment and think how many advertisement in your mobile you go through for a single day. There are huge. So mobile marketing is also very important marketing communication option. Now, there are also personal selling, public relation and publicity. And these are also the marketing communication options that improve the effectivity of your previous works. See, public relation promotes and protects a company's image or its individual products. Buzz marketing guidelines, keep it simple, tell us what's new. But before that, let's tell me what is buzz marketing. Buzz marketing means you are creating a buzz in your target customer about your product or your service. So through public relation and publicity, you can also communicate your customers. Identify the choice criteria in developing integrated marketing communication program. Students, here the question is, when you are developing an IMC program as an integrated marketing program, what are the criteria that you should remember or you should choose, you should evaluate? There are a company carefully integrates and coordinates many communication channels to deliver clear message. This is the definition of IMC to again make you recall it. Now see, integrated marketing communication is the voice of the brands. It a mean by which it can establish a dialogue and build relationship with consumers. It allows marketer to inform, persuade, and provide incentives and remind consumer directly or indirectly. So students, in this part, you can understand the importance of integrated marketing communication or IMC when your advertisement plus sales promotion plus public relations, all of these are integrated and sending you a message, we call that IMC. And you can understand IMC is very vital for a company. Now, how can you develop IMC program? You can evaluate all the possible communication options that are available to you. You can now assess the different communications options and their strengths, and you can set different objectives. Determine the optimal mix. So when you will develop IMC program, you have to evaluate each and every option very carefully. Now, for assessing the collective impact of IMC program, the marketer's goal is to design an effective and efficient program. There are six relevant criteria known as six C's, which are used to assess the IMC program. So to assess IMC program, we have six criteria. Let's take a look at them. The first criteria is coverage. Coverage means what proportion of the target audience is reached by each communication options. So when you are saying thinking about the coverage, you are thinking the program that you have designed, how many customers it have actually covered or the message have actually reached. The second one is what is the per capita expense, as in how much have you actually spent for developing the program. See, in a picture, you can see the communication option A, that might be advertisement. The communication options B, that is your promotion. The communication option C, that is your, that is maybe your interactive marketing. And all of these are coming, what? Coming together. And when they are integratedly targeting or accessing the customer, then what happens? We call that IMC. And the whole set is the audience. It means the whole set is the audience. You always have to remember all the communication will have to be mixed and integrated at one place. And then your communication program will be successful. The third criteria is contribution. The collective effect on brand equity in terms of enhancing depth, improving strength, favorability, and uniqueness of brand association. So students, it means the program that you have designed in which how much you have made awareness about the product in your customer's mind, how much customers feels connected with that. Next comes commonality, the extent to which information conveyed by different communication options share meaning. Now, the fifth criteria is complementarity, the extent to which different association and linkages are emphasized across communication options. Students, for example, you think about Pepsi Cola. Now think Pepsi Cola is giving advertisement and saying that Pepsi Cola is sugar free, and in another advertisement Pepsi Cola is saying it's very sweet. So won't they clash, or won't there will be a conflict? So you have to always remember the messages that you are giving through communication options should have link and association among their messages. Then versatility, the extent to which information contained in a communication options work with different types of consumer, different communication history, different market segment. Your marketing program should cover different segment. Your marketing communication program should have versatility, should have uniqueness and creativity in the way how it's portraying the information. Students, final, what are the general marketing communication guidelines? See, the writer has given us some guidelines that we should follow when we are actually designing a marketing communication program. Let's take a look at the guidelines. First, you have to be analytical. You have to be curious about the customers. Be single-minded. Focus message on well-defined target market. Be integrative. Reinforce your message through consistency. The next guideline is be creative. Obviously, always remember marketing is a kind of creative job. If you don't have creativity in your messages, in your program, then your customer shall not be intrigued. Be observant. You have to observe and study your customers well. Be realistic. Understand the complexities in marketing communication. Be very patient, because the effectiveness of communication might take a long time. Now we have come to the summary of this chapter. Students, integrated marketing programs create brand knowledge. Brand knowledge again creates brand equity. There are four major marketing communication options: advertisement and promotions, events and experience, interactive marketing, and mobile marketing. Integrated marketing communication will increase brand awareness and brand association in the mind of customer. The last line is the whole will be greater than the sum of the parts. It means when you are only using advertisement or only promotion, that won't come of that value. Unless you are actually integrating them, blending all the programs in a proper way, that will bring the most benefit for your firm. So, students, in this chapter, we actually understood the different kinds of marketing programs. We understood the information processing models. We understood what is advertisement, how can we design that, what are the promotions, and all the marketing programs. We understood that well. Also, we understood what are the criteria for marketing communication, what are the guidelines that we have to follow. I hope all of these study will help you a lot to design marketing communication programs in future. Till then, end of chapter 6 for today. Thank you. I'm Afrojoma Twinkie, taking leave from all of you. Allah Hafiz. Shabai bhalo thakben.